all by myself in a faraway place there, Wally. Not so happy with you. But I will get over it. I am, after all, a duck.
All right. So I guess they bounce back. Very, very resilient, the duck folk. So yesterday we broadcasted live from an entertaining venue here in Cape May. Finn's, right next to the Ugly Mug, right on the main strip right there. Talked a little bit about booze and how that plays into your dietary intake. Today, what I wanted to talk about was,
speed it up there, Wally, we're all getting very bored.
Today what I wanted to talk about was, diet and travel, right? So, a lot of people, including myself, you spend a lot of time trying to, control your diet when you're at home, when you've got a normal schedule going, and then you go away for, you know, in this case, for me, just a couple of days, but sometimes longer than that. And you want to try to stay on top of it, you know, stay on top of your intake and your exercise, like you've been working so hard and for such a long time now. How do you do that when you are abroad, when you are on vacation or holiday? One of the things that I like to do, to be honest with you, this is a wonderful opportunity to plug my product, because this would be a great spot for Wabowlhead to come into play. But we don't have them down here in Cape May yet. Yet, being the operative word, I have had a... Yesterday, actually, had a very encouraging conversation. So this is kind of on a side note with a co-packer and a food scientist with regards to getting the next hurdle overcome with regards to my business, so that's kind of cool. I will talk about that in future episodes. But today, so what do? You head out, you know, you're on holiday, you're going to be, let's say, what do you do, Ferdinando the duck?
I don't need much, some grass, I'm okay with that. You can find it anywhere.
Right, but for us that, require, a little bit, something a little bit more substantial than some grass, no matter what kind of grass it is you're talking about. I like to, I food prep and I bring it with me. So, back here, this is a industrial size Wabowl, handmade by Wally himself. I try not to speak in the third person, but I just did. So anyway, this is a gluten-free. Grains, greens, beans, seeds. This is black beans, quinoa, milk, flaxseed, chicken breast. No non-fat Greek yogurt-based sauce, because I just eat it straight up. But that's one way to do it. So you freeze it and you bring it with you, and then you thaw it out like I do at home. Other thing to do is just to try to live by the concept of minimizing the bad and maximizing the good. Right? So you're on a holiday, you're going to...
Why do you keep saying holiday? Are we in the UK here, Wally? Are we...
Fernando the Duck, I started saying that term, from a bunch of, I guess I had heard it from a bunch of, European or maybe even Canadian, say, holiday, and, I think it better describes what it is that, we're talking about here. So, vacation, you're vacating the premises, you're getting away from something that eventually you have to come back to. Holiday is, I think, more of an optimistic term. So, I'm going with it.
Okay. I understand. Thank you for explaining.
So, the concept of maximizing the good, minimizing the bad, when you're on holiday, chances are you might be boozing it up, you might be eating a lot of confectionaries, a lot of candy, a lot of cookies, a lot of cakes, ice cream. And, the problem is that people will, you work all summer, or your lifestyle is such that you've... formulated in a way where, you're in good shape, you're happy where you're at, or you're improving, you're seeing results, and you go away for a week and you take 20 steps back. So, I'm not going to lie, I had some delicious cake last night, wonderful, and some more this morning, but, you try to do as good as you can. So rather than having some more cake for dessert, I said no. I had a couple grapes.
Yes, I saw you eating the grapes all the way from up here.
Minimize the good. I mean, maximize the good. Minimize the bad. And, you know, once you do get back to your normal schedule, if you have one, maybe you don't have one, maybe you're retired. You know? Like Big Walt, who was in one of the Wabowlheads yesterday. Anyhow, I hope that may help. It doesn't really give you all that clear of a roadmap to how you might minimize the bad and maximize the good. But, you know, a lot of people go by like 75-25, you know, 80% of the time you do the good stuff, so 20% of the bad you can, or 20% of the time you can kind of screw off. I'm more like a 95-5. And now that I've discovered nice cream, special props to my friend Mary for introducing me to them. And another thing is, if this audio thing keeps on if this video keeps on cutting out audio wise, I'm having a hard time hearing some of it. Let me know and I'll try to figure it out. Anyhow, my 5 minutes are up for Nando.
Yep, they're up. Tell them about tomorrow. We maybe be another fancy location or something.
Yeah, we're gonna try to broadcast live from another bar tomorrow. So, this is Wally Wabowlhead. Wally Wabowlhead's quick bite. Until tomorrow. Bye.